like to welcome you all to the 13th annual Apple Valley Christmas program. This is the graduating class of 1996. We're going to split the program again. As you can see, it's a packed house. We will invite you to depart if you wish at intermission time. PTA has gratefully set up cookies and donuts, cookies and cocoa and coffee from the library, and you can go up there and enjoy yourself after this session, and we'll also have an actual intermediate session. I'd like to welcome you again, introduce Mrs. Lund, who will be taking care of our 1996 graduating class song at first, and then Mr. Rob Fairbrook, who has put this wonderful program together, and he's right over here. Can we welcome these people, please?
Technology, you know, said it, it was that we were going to catch a dollar a gallon, and that's what that was.
You gotta sit in
there. But there's anything else you
want. I have a couple of those.
I did. I saw you. Right, right. He's got a beard that's long and white.
Stan's got a beard that's long and white.
Who comes around on a special night?
Stan comes around on a special night.
Special night.
Cap on his head.
Cap on his head.
To the friends.
Special night.
Beard that's white.
the way she is alive. Just a simple gift of giving makes you warm inside. Though the sighs are fleeting, it was not at all. Remember all the many big things started out as small. So if you have a gift worth giving, let it be your smile. Let it be a kind of word that makes a stranger stop a while.
Let it be a simple gift then, if the wish is why. Just a simple gift of giving makes you warm inside.
We saw.
Wisconsin State Department at 6. It's a tremendous program. And behind it, the company and the corporate.
Thank you. Thank you. yellow pages. Piece by
yellow
piece.
Pages.
Piece by piece. Piece by piece.
What's that name?
In the middle?
No, I just put it on. Oh,
wait. Yeah, she's got the wall. She's got three parts.
Yes, it's a special time of year, and it seems that none of us can go very far in any direction without running smack dab into Christmas. We see it in the magical array of lights, we touch it in the holly decorations, and we even hear it in the music piped through all the stores and shops. Yet perhaps the most charming of all the season's reminders are those which come to us through the courtesy of a man dressed in a gray suit with a large sack on his back. Why, he visits your home and mine more times in 1 year than any other person. And by now, you all know who I'm talking about, don't you? It's not Santa, he's the mailman. Mine brought this card the other day, and the poem inside seemed to have an old familiar ring to it. Here, let me read it to you and see what you think. Two nights before Christmas and all through the store, a quiet hush settles over the floor. The toys which remained were all on the shelves, awaiting the moment the clock would strike 12. The shoppers went home and the owner departed. It gave the appearance the holiday had started. Well, started for most, I guess you might say.
Bah, Christmas. Absolutely the worst time of the entire year. Each one starts earlier and ends later than the one before. Well, my crazy neighbor, he doesn't even take down his decorations anymore. You wait and see. Next year they'll be marching with jingle bells on the 4th of July. Look at this mess. Everyone's pushing and shoving like a bunch of crazy people. I tell you, I'll sure be glad when it's all over. Just makes double work for me. And I'm so tired. And I can't see straight. Oh, I think it was so good to set these tired bones down and smell. I think I'll just close my eyes for a minute. Just for a minute.
Stop joking around. Mr. McDuck can be the only chance we have to talk to somebody who's real.
Right.
Nothing's cheap like they the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And though the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of Nazareth David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes.
Camelback! You must mean hatchback!
high deck. Let's see what else is happening. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord showed none about them. And they were so afraid. And this angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign to all people. He shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
What's
a manger, Duck? As far as I know, Duck, it's nothing more than a rugged wooden trough that they put the food and hay for all the animals. I guess it was the only bed available.
Glory, glory, hallelujah to the newborn.
at least for me.
How do you mean, Mr. McDuff?
Well, Lanny, for all these years, I've been looking for Christmas. And tonight, for the first time, I think I've found it. You see, I always look for Christmas in people and presents and all that stuff. And when I didn't find it, I decided not to care. Now I understand that Christmas was there all the time, wrapped in those tiny strips of cloth and lying in a manger. Jesus wasn't born just to give the whole world a big celebration. He was born so that we could know peace and forgiveness. He was born for me.
Thank you.
And how about a big one for Mr. Fairbrook, who has to go through another one next time? Oh.